we recently traveled to Tokyo to meet a young man hoping to bring about a new golden era for Japanese gymnastics. Kohei Uchimura is the reigning men's all-around world champion. Hailing from Nagasaki, the 21-year-old has practiced gymnastics since the age of 3, having grown up with it at his parents' sports center. These days, he trains and studies at the Nippon Sports Science University in Tokyo, where he's coached by former national team gymnast Yoshiaki Hatakada.
In terms of his gymnastic technique, I think he's pretty much the finished article. The same can obviously be said for most of the world's top gymnasts. But he has a way of being able to clearly visualize the movements in his head and then execute them, which sets him aside from everybody else. He's certainly very gifted in this area, compared with most other gymnasts. In addition to that, his sense of positioning in the air is very good indeed. In fact, I'd say his sense of positioning in general is truly outstanding.
As an all-around gymnast, Kohei spreads his training time across the 6 different disciplines that men compete in: the vault, pommel horse, rings, floor, and the high and parallel bars. While gymnastics demands huge levels of physical exertion, Kohei doesn't spend any time lifting weights, having gained the requisite strength from years of training on the various apparatus.
The best gymnasts are both young and experienced. The sport's current rules require a number of skills which certainly make it harder in terms of physicality. So it's true that it is more difficult for older gymnasts. Kohei Uchimura started gymnastics at a very early age. And so he's building up his experience through appearing at international competitions, like the Olympics and the World Championships.
A year after the Olympics, Kohei competed at the Artistic Gymnastics World Championships in London. Another impressive performance saw him win the men's all-around world title, becoming Japan's youngest ever gymnastics world champion.
The World Championships were 12 months on from the Olympics, so there were definitely greater expectations. I did feel a bit of pressure, but the fact that I managed to achieve that result in the competition gave me a lot of confidence.
At the Beijing Olympics, he wasn't sure whether he could compete with the world's top gymnasts. After Beijing, he began to realize that he was in a position to aim for the gold medal by the time the World Championships came around. It was something he worked hard for, and thankfully, something he was able to achieve. I think the sense of achievement was definitely greater for him in the World Championships last year.
The only thing to detract from Kohei's gold medal-winning performance at the World Championships was the lack of a Chinese participant in the men's all-around competition. In recent years, China has become the dominant force in both men's and women's gymnastics, winning the team titles and the majority of the individual events at the sport's last 3 major championships. The retirement of a number of gymnasts from China's Olympic gold medal-winning teams, including men's all-around champion Yang Wei, has left many looking forward to a closer contest between the two nations at the World Championships in Rotterdam in a few weeks.
This year's World Championships will be the first group competition since the Olympics. It'll give us our first opportunity to find out how much we've reduced the gap between ourselves and China, and whether we have any chance of overtaking them. I suppose we're now in a position to say that the world's top gymnastics nation is either China or Japan. Other countries are obviously at a similar level as well, but at the Olympics in 2008, China was by far the strongest nation. The World Championships this year will be the place to find out how much that situation has changed.
Kohei and the rest of Japan's national gymnastics team practice at the Ajinomoto Training Center in Tokyo. Opened in 2004, the facility caters for the majority of Japan's Olympic sports teams. Kohei's multiple successes on the international stage, combined with the fact that he's won Japan's national title for the past 3 years, have made him one of the most famous athletes in the country, meaning he's frequently in demand with the Japanese media. He'll be under the spotlight once again soon, as he attempts to defend his world championship crown. His coach believes that all Kohei Uchimura has to do is to stay healthy and fit to retain his all-around title, and then to focus on the London Games in 2012 and win that elusive Olympic gold medal.
Even now, what he's capable of doing already distinguishes him from what most other gymnasts can do. So it wouldn't be a major problem if he stays at the same level. But I'm sure he's got his own particular goals that he's aiming for. So it's mainly about helping him and seeing whether or not he can achieve those goals. It wouldn't be good for anyone if he tries too hard and gets injured. So I would like to continue working with him closely, and hopefully we can help him reach his peak at the next Olympic Games.